Snoop Dogg's album shows Trump dead in morgue, rapper freaks as sick secret comes out. Snoop Dogg got the attention of the Secret Service after he released a music video in which a President Donald Trump lookalike was shot with a toy gun. The video was much more graphic than it sounds, but that has not stopped the aging rapper from doubling down on the Trump imagery. Now, after featuring a dead body with a toe tag that reads Trump on his new album, he is freaking out as his sick secret is exposed. Don't miss this. Snoop Dogg, whose real name is Calvin Cordoza Herbrodes Jr., is nothing more than an aging rapper. His career peaked in the 1990s, and since then, it's been all downhill. That was until he latched onto President Trump's huge amount of press and decided to exploit taking up the leftist cause. Last year, he came out with a new album called Lavender, and his song of the same name became infamous, only because he had a pot-smoking Trump clown in it, which he shot with a toy gun. Contrary to what he may think, Snoop Dogg is not the smartest rapper ever, but he did figure out that anything bashing Trump was going to get him publicity. So, with his career in the toilet, he decided to continue with his Trump imagery, and once again, he went too far. The president says he wants to make America great again. F-C-K that S-H-T. We gonna make America crip again, Snoop Dogg says in the track. It's not a statement or a political act, it's just good music. Certain people feel like we should make America great again, but that time they're referring to always takes me back to separation and segregation, so I'd rather make America crip again, Snoop Dogg said in a statement obtained by Rolling Stone. Snoop Dogg has no idea what he is talking about. Takes him back to separation and segregation? What does that mean? Snoop Dogg grew up in North Long Beach, California, and yes, it is a crime-ridden area, but there was no separation or segregation going on in his lifetime. His sick secret is what he is really referring to by saying make America crip again. Notice the album cover is also entirely blue, as the Michigan Daily points out, and that is not to represent the Democrats. No, it's blue because that is the color that represents the Crips gang. The Crips are one of the oldest gangs, and their rivals are the Bloods, who wear red. Snoop was a member of the Rollin' 20 Crips gang in the East Side area of Long Beach, although he stated in 1993 that he never joined a gang. This is making Snoop freak out, according to insiders, as his past is coming back to haunt him. Michelle Malkin exposed Snoop Dogg in her article Snoop Dogg's Top 15 Rap Sheet Items. So, when Snoop Dogg says he wants to make America crip again, that is a sick slap to law enforcement, many who were murdered at the hands of these gang members. It glamorizes gang life and is a direct appeal to gang members across the country. Even leftist fans of Snoop Dogg are calling him out, as the Michigan Daily reports, Snoop's message hits a wall when met with lines like, me and my homies gang bang on the field, and, locked in, lock out, talk shit, get socked out, that only seem to emphasize and encourage the senseless violence and prideful disputes within black communities. A lot of people glorify the gang banging and violence but forget that in the beginning, the Crips' main and sole purpose was to be the reflection of the Black Panthers, said Snoop, according to Rolling Stone. Wow, gangs started out as a reflection of the Black Panthers? That might be the big problem as the aging rapper addresses Southern California gang life. Not only is he glorifying one of the most ruthless gangs in America, he is ignorant, seeing President Trump as the villain the nutjobs on the left make him out to be. Donald Trump's economic success includes all parts of America, even the ghettos. The ghettos are a construct of the Democrats, and if any of these idiots could figure that out, they would be running away from the likes of Maxine Waters and her cohorts. However, Snoop Dogg doesn't really care about Trump or healing the black community, he cares about only one color, green, the color of money. Too bad this new album will put him back on the radar of the Secret Service, and it's such a dud he won't be able to buy new bling anytime soon.